Hey guys, it's Cindy, Palm Springs Cindy. I'm still at my mom's house because she's recovering from her eye surgery. And since I've been here, you know, the house is quiet and there's no visitors. We're trying to keep things really restful so she can get her healing underway, which has been. But I have been on YouTube and I've discovered a conversation on YouTube that I have really enjoyed. And so I want to step into that conversation. Now, part of my YouTube fun and the reason why I wanted to get on YouTube and the reason why I like watching who I call my beauty divas is because they're my age and they talk and relate. And so at any rate, several gals have started a conversation about memories from when they were younger. Now, I think that is part of the fun of YouTube, that we don't just have to talk about our lives today, our lives getting older, aging gracefully, certain makeups or skin care that works for aging faces. But I also like the idea of being able to reminisce together and share some of our memories together. So with that, I want to talk a little bit. It's totally off the cuff. It's just something I want to talk about. And that is, I'm going to sort of reminisce a little bit about my early childhood. And then, you know, I won't finish the whole thing, but I can like do part two, part three, or whatever. So I was thinking, you know, I'm a baby boomer. I was born in 1950. My father is a World War II veteran, although he passed away a few years ago. And after the war, I lived in Los Angeles, right by the LA airport. And my father and mother, their housing was very, very sparse. And in fact, they were just beginning to build tract homes because the government and builders realized the need for more housing. So we lived in a duplex. My grandparents bought a duplex. They lived in the front, we lived in the back. A two bedroom, one bath house that was a duplex, but a ginormous backyard. And it was very typical of that 50s. It was a neighborhood with sidewalks and street lights and curbs and gutters and alleyways. And in fact, those were the days where we had incinerators and we would burn our trash until the government or the cities decided it was too toxic to have all that going on in the air. So at any rate, that, you know, I think about my little duplex house that I grew up in. So some of my fond memories are like, I remember my mom would send me to the liquor store. We had a corner liquor store for, you know, if she ran out of whatever, you know, she could give me some change and I would walk over to the liquor store. But when I would go, I would always ask for an empty cigar box. Usually they had them. So remember those delicious smelling cigar boxes that were like treasure chests to us. I remember skating and remember those horrible skate keys and those horrible skates that we skated with and our shoes would come out of them and we would fall. I remember jump roping and double dutching and playing hopscotch and trying to figure out with my girlfriends which was the best lagger, you know, to throw in the hopscotch square and get it there within the boundaries. I remember riding my bicycle and you know, when the street lights would come on and my parents would say, be sure and come home by the time the street lights are on. And coming home and watching Sheriff John and drinking my milk according to his red light, green light game. Game. And in school, I went to Catholic school, and that is a whole nother issue. But when I was in school, we usually were carpooled, and so if we were there early, depending upon whose parents drove us, if we were there early, we would have to go to mass. And so all of, so we didn't want to go to mass because we didn't want to have to sit there and be quiet and everything. So we would hide in the bathrooms, and we would hide, we'd put our feet up on the toilets, but sure shooting those nuns would open the door and, who's in here? And pull us out of the stalls and make us get into mass. Which was okay, except that I was terrified of the nuns. I was terrified of the whole idea of the statues with the, the crown of thorns on Jesus's head and the blood dripping down his face and the nails in his hands and the strictness and the meanness of the nuns in those days, at any rate. And so I was just a very soft, gentle little girl and didn't need to be yelled at to be obedient. And so I have, some not very good memories of my elementary years. And I think somehow that's translated into why I went into teaching, because I wanted to give other children the chance and a loving experience that maybe I didn't really have. So I remember, my Catholic school days and wearing the uniforms and rolling up the waistband of the uniforms to make my skirt shorter. And I remember walking, we'd take the bus home, but sometimes I would walk and get off at a different stop and go to my friend's house after school. And we would watch a show that many of you will not know, but many of you will remember the show and will crack up when I say it. We used to watch the Soupy Sales show. And we would watch White Fang and Black Tooth, and this show became a cult phenomena. I mean, I think Frank Sinatra was on it. All these big stars started getting on this Soupy Sales show, and it truly was hysterical. Kind of like the Pee Wee Herman to come later on, but just quirky as can be. So we would watch Soupy Sales, and then I would usually have to go home because I would end up walking home or taking the bus down to get to my street. But also, ladies, don't forget the whole Dick Clark phenomena. And I phenomena. And I wasn't so much into Dick Clark, but I had a 4-year-old, a sister almost 4 years older than I am. So she was watching Dick Clark and watching the American Bandstand, and she knew the couples that danced together, and of course all the songs. And so I was just starting to get into that, but I wasn't quite there yet. I was still pretty elementary school-ish, enjoying Soupy Sales and Felix the Cat cartoons. So anyway, with that being said, if you were born in 1950, televisions were not very, people just didn't have televisions. And the whole cosmetic industry was not available to our mothers, perhaps, but certainly not to young ladies, and not to the extent that we have them now. And oh, one quick thing I just dawned on. Sometimes my girlfriends and I, when we would leave school, we would get off the bus in Westchester by Westchester High School. I think it was Westchester, maybe it was Englewood High. Anyway, we would go to the Woolworths there. Now, I know everyone my age remembers Woolworths. And we would sit down at the counter and we would order cherry Cokes and French fries. And we would sit, and they had the little music boxes that you could put your nickel in. And so we would go there and have our sodas and listen to music. And that was just hot time on the town that night. So if you remember things like coming home when the street lights are on, if you remember skating and skate keys, Woolworths and Cherry Cokes, Soupy Sales and Felix the Cat, then yes, we are baby boomers, and we certainly, just as we celebrate this time in our life as we're getting older, looking back on those fun memories are part of who we are today. So I look back fondly on a lot of my childhood memories, and those are just a few that I wanted to share today. Okay, if you haven't already, please subscribe to my channel, Palm Springs Cindy, and stay tuned because I want to talk about the next part of my life. It's kind of interesting. Okay.